our friend. I still and will always count myself his friend. Friendships have many themes, but a major theme of ours was the immense fact, the immense dilemma and sorrow of land destruction. In his determined, capable, and passionate opposition to this destruction, Harry was what Thoreau called a standard man. He was, in every way, rare. I doubt that any man of his time had more courage than Harry Caudill. Living in coal country, among reminders of its violent history, his law practice keeping him daily in view of the mining companies, he attacked them unremittingly in state government, in the courts, in books, in magazine articles, in letters and articles in newspapers, in hundreds of speeches and interviews. He never quit, and he never flinched. Until his final illness, Harry never stopped. A man of courage, constant to the end.
I'm proud of him for what he was able to do to control his own mind.
I think the most important people for us to give our consideration and our attention to are not the people who are here in this room tonight, not even the people in the world today, but all those millions and billions who will come after and who will occupy the lands that we claim today, who will live on the lands that we conserve or tar up today, who will drink the water that we pollute or purify today. They are the millions of people who have no voice. Somebody has to speak for the unborn.